It's trade seats. You can take your stuff and... Are you okay taking, well, you may take notes, you may not, but are you okay taking notes a little more in the dark so we can cool it down a little in here?
Yes!
Yeah, okay. If we can control the lights and cool it down a little more, we'll try to cool off a little bit. But have you all traded seats? Great, okay. Have a seat in someone else's seat. The reason why I'm having you do that is because that's exactly what I had to do in my brain in order to feel comfortable sitting in the seat of a builder. Let that sink in for a second. You were just sitting in your own seat, you got real comfortable all day long, right? Maybe you didn't want to move. Maybe you were thinking, why is she making me change seats? It's kind of crazy, I don't want to change seats. This is my spot. I've been in this spot all day long. I love my spot. But you just change seats. And if it's difficult to change a literal seat, think about how difficult it can be to change the seat that you're sitting in with this company. And if you are not a builder and don't see yourself as sitting in the seat of a builder, maybe the first thing you need to do is change where you're sitting. And we can all do that. And that change starts here. It starts in your belief system. So finding new business builders, okay, stand up if you joined this company before purchasing any oils, you knew you wanted to build a business with doTERRA. This is before you bought an oil. You knew you were coming in as a business builder. Excellent. Now look at the percentage of that compared to everyone else. Have a seat. 90% and more. I don't know what the exact statistic is, but it's well above 90. It might even be 96%. Once you get to silver, you get an account manager. You can ask a lot of questions. They can look at your back office. They can see things through their program that we can't see in our own back office. So when I do those calls, I usually just say, look at my business with fresh eyes and tell me what you see. And that's how I let them ask me questions and talk to me, which is great. So I'm very open to being nudged a little out of my comfort zone. If I really want this to work for my why, which is a huge why, my husband and I live here in Kernersville, on the other side toward High Point. And we're on a property right now that we don't own. It's 47 acres. And for a few years now, we've been running a family ministry. We're serving a lot of people. We do not draw a salary. So when I started with doTERRA, I couldn't build a business by giving out incentives that I couldn't afford. So I've never given out a book to say, here, join my team and I'll give you this free stuff. And I really struggled with that because I saw that other people had the luxury to be able to do that. And I thought, I will never be able to build a business because I can't do that. Because my husband would say, we can't afford that. We can't go backwards and dig a little hole, hoping that we're going to pull out of it later. So we had to really put it out there and say, okay, is this a business? And if so, how do we get there? And I was very frustrated my first several months because I love people, and I saw business as being not me, and I had to change my mindset, and so I asked Mike, because I loved doTERRA, I loved oils, I've loved essential oils for a long time. I was using them from other companies, really loved, I went to Crystal's first class that Tanya led over the webcam, and I really went because I love Crystal, and I'm her friend. But I sat there kind of with my arms crossed, thinking, I use essential oils. I love my essential oils. Tell me something I don't already know about essential oils. And I was really kind of prideful, okay? She told me a lot that night. Tanya shared a lot that I did not know about essential oils. And my son needed essential oils. And he had some healing happen because of these essential oils. Of course, I joined. Well, with the ministry that we do, we have a lot of people who need to heal. And so that's my driving force. So the first several months, I wasn't really paying attention to the business plan, and I had a lot of people in my front line like this, and I didn't even know that there were a certain amount of days where you had to move them. I wasn't educating myself in the business because I was so excited about sharing and so excited about educating myself about the oils. That's over 95% of us. So as things started to grow, and I started to jump into that education, I love to teach. I'm a homeschool mom. I love teaching my kids. When we lived in Atlanta, Georgia, I've done a lot in children's ministry. I love to teach. Write songs, write things, choir musicals and stuff. And I taught in a classical education arts school in Atlanta, and I loved it. So I love to teach. I love to see light bulbs go off. So I was enjoying that. But I still carried this self-consciousness about finding a business builder in myself. And how am I supposed to find other business builders if I can't find it in me? So really, that's your first question, is how do you find the business builder that's inside of you? I want to tell you about a girl in Ohio-Kentucky border. Her address is actually Kentucky. She lives right outside of Cincinnati, and she's a niece of someone who joined my team early on. And this woman was here earlier this morning. She joined probably 2 years ago because she needed to heal. Okay? She really was on a personal healing journey. And that's how she and I connected. Well, she was here today because of her healing. Now she wants to build. She was there all along. So how do you find business builders like that? They're probably already on your team. You help them heal, and eventually they'll want to build because they're going to want to help somebody else heal. So what happened with her was she was so excited about the personal healing that she was experiencing, she told her niece, who lives outside of Cincinnati. Her niece began using essential oils for a very long time, and she almost died several times growing up. When she was engaged, they didn't even know if she would make it to the wedding day because she was always on that balancing act of near death. And she experienced so much healing in her personal body that when I went for Diamond Club and I was able to travel to Cincinnati, I gave this class. It was like a whirlwind. They're all Portuguese. They were speaking in other languages. It was beautiful. But literally, this woman was just so excited about her healing. I didn't know her story. I didn't know her. I just knew she was using oils regularly. You know? She was asking a lot of questions. Well, it was so awesome. Her door of her house was just like this constant opening and closing. Toddlers running around everywhere. It was very distracting to do a class. And I was thinking, I'm here for Diamond Club, and I need to be signing up people. What is this? Like, this is chaos. Well, that chaos was because of her healing. And through the end of that 2 days of being there with her family, finally all done, she sat there just smiling the whole time I'm there. She smiled, and she said, thank you so much. So-and-so, who you Zytoscan, has a serious drug addiction. So-and-so has, and she stated all these things, she goes, this is going to change my family and friends. So, fast forward, 1 month from that day, she was knocking on the door of Premier and has never looked at the business. And I told her, I said, you're almost a Premier. So now her aunt, who was here earlier today, who started out with her own healing first, she wants to learn how to build a business because that allowed her, she's an elite as well, right? You know how the plan works. So these two elites don't even know how the business model works. They don't even know how to read the unilevel sheets. They have no boss as far as the numbers go because they don't know how it works. So the second month I went up there and this girl and her massage therapist friend rented out two restaurants and they had all day events. And they have this revolving door of people. So at the end of the day, it's like 9:30 at night, we're all exhausted. And she's like, cake making is my business. Oils is not my business. I said, sweetie, you have a business. You have a doTERRA business, and now you need to understand it. And you're walking in it because of your healing. So I want to inspire you. There is no super magic secret to finding builders. Now, There probably are, but so many of those methods have been covered today, and how you communicate in a class, and how you invite, and how you follow up, all of that you can find in other people's stuff. But I really felt like my role today is to tell you, from a person who really didn't know that I could be a business builder, that I have a business. And it's growing really well, and it's in the momentum to be able to provide ministry for our family that,
I'm gonna cry. I'm emotional. That's just me.
But I'm walking in it because I said to my husband, if I have to push people for sales, I can't do this. And he said to me, because he knows me really well, he's a very good man, and he said to me, Amy, you need to find yourself in this. And when you can figure out how to be fully you and do what needs to be duplicated, but as you, then you're going to succeed. But until you can do that, this isn't going to work for you. So we gave it 1 month. This was the month of December, 2 Decembers ago. We said, all right, took my little quiet time with God. I said, all right, Jesus, this is January 1st. If this isn't moving forward by January 1st, I guess I'm just going to share with friends, which is great, and serve my family. And at this point, I was already doing a lot of aroma touches, and this was just a big, huge part of my life. December just exploded because I changed my seat. I changed my belief. And I was able to make it mine. And the Lord said to me, your mission is your business. And your mission and your business model is serving to the last drop. And when that landed on my spirit, I knew that this wasn't just a business. This is a calling. Because if you knew my story and you knew the heritage I have of illness and medication, and that cycle that you can't get out of. We're living in a time where people need out, and we need to help them. So when you find what God has gifted you to do the way that He has gifted you to do it, you can change that seat, and you can walk with confidence, and you can say, eventually you're going to want all these oils. I just know that, because eventually you're going to want to use everything that doTERRA has to offer. But let's get you started where you can start, and we'll work together for your healing. Because the difference in medication and doTERRA, we all know, medication has its place, but it brings respite and it brings reprieve and relief to the body so that the body can heal. But the synthetic medication can't get in there and actually do the healing the body does. So what we are giving people isn't a business. We're giving them life. We are giving our cellular structure the ability to heal. And that's what you and I carry. So should we be afraid of that? Should we be so self-conscious that we rob our neighbor of that opportunity too? Or our relative who thinks we're just kooky? You know, it might take 12 times. But the way that you're going to find them is by living in a wholeness of your own that wants people walking in and out of the door with toddlers all around saying, Christy, how did you heal? You're different. And when you're different, you're going to be building more than a business. And you're going to be helping other people rebuild their lives. We are sick when we do not need to be staying sick forever. And that's you gotta keep your mission, whatever your mission is. I made all these notes and I haven't even looked down. So I don't know where all that came from, but it was for you, so. But the art, I was gonna make these pictures, because I love art. I was gonna make a sketch, but I ran out of time because of Diamond Club and all that. But okay, so over here I was gonna just have to imagine it, okay? If I drew a sketch really, really fast, it might be okay. But what about on this side? What if I drew a sketch and it took days of going back to it? And days of remaking this area or shading this area? Okay, if I'm trying to build my business fast, I'm going to miss a lot of detail. Now you can build your business fast, but in the process, help people shade, bring them in. You know, on one of our pages, I posted a doodle sketch of like this flower. Because, you know, if you do the, what's your personality? I'm like a squiggly circle. So I was like, I'm circular because I love community and I love people, but I'm a squiggly line because, like Lacey, I don't want to do things the way that it says all the time because I feel like it loses itself in it. So what is a squiggly circle? It's kind of like a flower. And I love flowers. I'm like, I always kind of have flowers on the foot. So I was like, I can be a flower, okay? I can flourish in this and grow, but I want to help other people join my team and find their niche. If they're square, we need to draw in some square stuff over here on the team. We need to make this picture really beautiful with all the squares. And the squiggly lines, they need to artsy it up over here, and in this way, we all work together. It turns out very beautiful. But even more beautiful than that, I have a painting at home and I was going to bring it, but we did a sermon series with our house group, church, family, ministry team. And it was exactly that. I ran out of time. I was very busy. And I just threw a sketch together, and that was all I could do for that Sunday. So what I ended up doing, I said, Mike, we've got other creative people. Let's just let someone else take it from there. So someone else added to it the next week. And then someone else added to it the week after that. And each week, the painting grew. Now to me, I look at it and it still looks unfinished. But isn't it always? Is art ever really finished? So I was going to bring it in to show you when more people got involved with their own, who they were, it turned into something so much more beautiful than what I started with. And that's how I see my team. So I help them find themselves and help them build where they are with what they have. So I always ask them, what is your purpose? How can I help you? What are you doing right now with doTERRA? How can I serve you? What do you need from me to help support you? I'm not enabling them by doing all the work for them, but I want them to dig deep and find out where they are. And what's really cool is for a long time, I would come to these group events and I would be the only person sitting from my team. And last year I went to the convention and I was the only representative for my team. And now there's a whole group of us. And I'm so excited because they're all building when they're ready. But guess what? They're people that were already on my team. They're just getting up on their seat. And they're doing more with what they've already had. Now, I'm also a lot less afraid now to talk to the waitress in the restaurant, give out my card, and say, you've been serving in this restaurant for how many years? 4 years. You're an amazing person, and I love the way you serve people. If you ever want to leave the restaurant business, I have this oils business, and you're exactly the kind of person that I would love to work with. Here's my card. And those kind of conversations, which I never would have had before, have started happening in my life. And it's really awesome. I have my timer here so that I don't go, we've got four more minutes. Okay. So the art, you want to build in a way that's artistic, but here's something you need to know about art. Order and numbers are in everything. Right? We don't have to be afraid of them. When you look at a teardrop under a microscope, it's very beautiful. If you look at fractals, they're very orderly, right? If you look at essential oils under the microscope, they're these beautiful designs, and in every single thing that God has designed, there's a number to it, there's a pattern to it, and there's order. So if you're like me, and you're like, I really want to build a business, but it's so not me, or whatever, just know, the number and the orderliness is a good thing. Embrace it, put your personality, and find those people who are those squiggly lines who are like, I don't know how to share, I don't know how to build. Help them find themselves and how they do, because all of us share things. We all do. Someone earlier, I think it was Jessica, said, I've shared so many things for lactation, right? That milk enhancement, whatever, whatever. So we all sell stuff. We just need to figure out what motivates us and how to share in such a way that it matches with our belief. Okay, so let me see if I covered all this. If you have the people on your team who are in positions, like you didn't know what you were doing at first, so they're just in this one spot where you really need them to be building and they're not, make sure that they didn't come into this because they need to heal. Do not push and put pressure on a person who is going through a deep healing and force them to build your business. That is detrimental. And I've seen on some of the Facebook groups out there, and I had to shut off notifications on some things, where somebody has like this ailment, everybody's talking about this ailment, blah, 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 and the person might say, and I so wish that they would WXYZ because my business, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, are we not creative enough to find another spot on your team to put your energy? I think one of the biggest blessings about being in Diamond Club was I threw it out to my team and I said, whoever is excited and enthusiastic enough to host an event far away, I'll come to you. And what I didn't do, which I guess is good and bad, I'm not going to be Diamond by the end of Diamond Club, because what I didn't do was look at where I needed my business to build to be a Diamond and focus there. And some people do that, and they hit Diamond, it's awesome. I couldn't do that. I just had I read somebody's blog, and I liked her style, and the way she did it was what I did. So I was like, I can do that. If you're excited, I'll come. And what happened was, I'm a little lopsided now, because these legs over here, they were excited, and that's where the energy was. But you know what? That has been amazing, because now I know where I can focus myself. So instead of getting frustrated with someone who's not building, figure out how you can serve better in those areas to support them, or to build in that spot that you need outside of them while they're taking the time to get there. And they may get there and they may not, but that's their business, right? We all are in charge of our own business, and what I don't want my people on my team to feel like is that they make my business. I want to support them fulfilling their business, because if I'm serving them, I'm like the girl in Kentucky, Cincinnati, who's just out to help people heal, and then when people come in, she's serving those people for sharing with others, and because doTERRA is awesome, they've already designed the compensation plan to work with that. So when you serve others and you help them serve others and you put the support where the person who was doing the work put the energy, it all balances out. So don't look back on it and go, man, I made so many mistakes. That's a negative thought. You capture that negative thought and you speak life into your business. You speak life into that person. There are no mistakes, because with art, what do? You just recreate around it. You make it beautiful. And every single person in your business is beautiful. So I've gone 1 minute over. Let me just make sure. Okay, contentment. Be content. Be excited about where you're headed, but be content along the way, or you will lose yourself. Your belief in others is so essential. It is so essential. And when you can speak that belief over them, you will be amazed at what they will do. There's no mistakes. You can rework it. Build in a way, this is my last comment, if I had my team up here as a work of art, I want to have done every decision that I made with integrity and with service in mind, so that I could take my paintbrush at the end and sign my name on it, and know that every person who walks through that gallery will look at that piece of art and know that it's a reflection of that artist. So if you've done things that you regret, get out your paintbrush, make some things right, apologize to some people, empower them. Whatever you need to do, rework that in such a way that you will be proud to sign your name to your business, and then use that integrity and that life and pour that artistry into those around you.